Oh, hello, bus. Yes, indeed. Ah, there we are. Greetings, everyone, and welcome to another exciting Twitch session. Well, no sooner have we finished the original portal than hot on its heels, we're off for more adventures and questing for cake and lots of horrible fail as I try to solve completely obvious puzzles and get really stumped. We're gonna play some Portal 2. Alright, so let's get right into it, shall we? There we go. Okay, so we're starting very fresh. I barely even opened the game up here, so... sound? Yes, we do. All right. Oh, here we are. All right. Awesome. Now, I've never played a single second of Portal 2, so this is going to be completely new to me. All I know is some of the robot characters, just because I've seen some videos of them. But as for the game itself, I have no idea. Alright, so... let's get into it, shall we? And Stout is wondering if there's going to be an update. That's very possible. Here, let's make these colors a little more portally, shall we? Cam... oh, yeah, of course. Let's do that, shall we? Well, while it's doing that, we're going to do this. There we go. That's a little more partly. Partly wardly. Oh, great. Just go. Do it. Why are you asking me permission? Obviously, I want you to do that. Do-do-do-do-do. And... should probably make this orange. Alright, so I'll be the exit portal, and my Patreon link will be the entry portal. Or the other way around, if you want to do it that way. Yeah, you can really tell that I've never played this before, because it hasn't run any of the updates. So, this is a blind run, much like the first one, so expect lots and lots of fail. Such as me failing to install the updates before we play the game. We're off to a rockin' start. In case you're wondering what happened to the cake at the end of the last one, Rosie and I ate it. So, it was wonderful. It was so delicious and moist. So, we'll see how things go. Maybe we'll get another cake for the end of this one. Or not. We'll see if I have money at the time that I finish this one. I do have gift cards, so maybe I can get a gift card cake. Who knows? Maybe we'll just get a box of donuts. Donuts are good. I like donuts. Very cool. Wow, it's got a ton of updates. Holy moly. Holy guacamole, Batman. Installing. Thank God for fast internet. Downloading, installing, and running updates while streaming. Oh, yeah. Multitasking for the win. Oh, yeah. Worm Dizzy says, I always do that update thing with Defiance. Yeah, I gotta get back to Defiance. I haven't played that in so bloody long. I am up to date on the show. I watched Season 3, basically, as it aired. And that may be it. I haven't heard anything about Season 4, but if it ends where it ended in Season 3, then that's okay. Right. Good. Here we go. I may have to adjust where I am in relation to game stuff, but we'll deal with that as we go. Oh. Well, that's pretty cool. I'm totally covering the side of her head, aren't I? Oh, well, whatever. I'm sure we'll see this screen many, many more times throughout the course of the game, so... Here we go. So the only thing I know about Portal 2 is it's apparently a little more story-driven than the first one. Which is good, because the first one seemed to set up a bunch of mystery and then didn't really pay any of it off. So I'm kind of curious where things go from here. Like, it really didn't answer any questions at all, other than GLaDOS was evil. Beyond that, we don't really know anything, so... Configuring trophies, validating profile information. Alright, let's go. I think I got this game brand new, factory sealed, for about $3. It was on clearance when I was working at Future Shop, and, got it dirt cheap. I actually got Portal 2 long before I managed to find the orange box for Portal 1, so we'll see. So that's one of the reasons it took me so bloody long to get around to playing these. Holy crap! Portal 2. Finish config. How many trophies do you need to configure? Seriously. Oh, didn't you know? Portal 2 is in the Guinness Book of World Records for the most trophies. 6 billion trophies. That's why it took so long. Oh. Press select to access the Steam overlay. Dare I do that? Oh. Steam platform is now available on PlayStation 3. Signage. Oh! Well, that's cool. Cross-platform chat, play on your computer. Yeah, you get the Steam key with the game here. Now, I don't know if you can play on PS3 and Steam, like, and play with someone who's playing it on Steam at the same time. But I don't know. That'd be worth checking out. How's the audio, by the way? Is the audio okay? As far as you guys can tell? I'll just wait for a, something. Anybody? How's the audio? Testing, blah, 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 blah. This is me talking while the game music plays, and, it's good? Alright, cool. Let's do this here. Single player. Sixth Sense in Motion. Options. Just quickly check control options here. Controller. Yes, thank you. And that should all be fine. Alright, folks, here we go. Assuming we'll have a little cinematic here. A lot more detail in the artwork here. Holy moly. Oh, is this this is the remnants of GLaDOS, I think, isn't it? Whom we defeated at the end of the first one. I'll put a link up in the YouTube video for those who don't want to sit through all this bullshit and just get to the game. I did that for the first one, and, yeah. I try to be considerate of people that way. Of course, if you're watching the YouTube version and use that link, you're not hearing me say any of this, because you will have just skipped past all of it, so... Ha ha! Sucks to be you! You're missing all of this gold right now. Okay, well, it looks like you're loaded. Nihilist says, I come for the bullshit. That's right, it's all about the bullshit. Holy crap, Portal 2, load faster.
Good morning. You have been in suspension for 50 days. In compliance with state and federal regulations, all testing candidates in the Aperture Science Extended Relaxation Center must be revived periodically for a mandatory physical and mental wellness exercise. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, look up at the ceiling. Good. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, Look down at the floor. Good. This completes the gymnastic portion of your mandatory physical and mental wellness exercise.
Gymnastics.
There is a framed painting on the wall. Please go stand in front of it. This is art. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, stare at the art.
I'm staring at
you should now feel mentally reinvigorated. If you suspect staring at art has not provided the required intellectual sustenance, reflect briefly on this classical music. Good. Now, please return to your bed.
Aww. Fine.
Good morning. You have been in suspension for
9999999.
Hello? Anyone in there?
Subjects should vacate the
Hello?
Center immediately.
Ah, God. You look good. Looking good, actually. Are you okay? Are you... Don't answer that. I'm absolutely sure you're fine. There's plenty of time for you to recover. Just take it slow.
Please prepare for emergency evacuation.
Stay calm. Stay calm. Prepare. It's all the same. Prepare. It's all fine. All right? Don't move. I'm going to get us out of here. Oh, you might want to hang on to something. Word of advice. Up to you. You all right down there? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Hello?
I'm fine. Thank you. Kind of wondering what the fuck's going on.
Most test subjects do experience some cognitive deterioration after a few months in suspension. Now, you've been under for quite a lot longer, and it's not out of the question that you might have a very minor case of serious brain damage. But don't be alarmed, all right? Although if you do feel alarmed, try to hold on to that feeling, because that is the proper reaction to being told that you've got brain damage. Do you understand what I'm saying at all? Does any of this make any sense? Just tell me. Just say yes.
Oh.
Okay, what you're doing there is jumping. You just jumped. But never mind. Say apple. Apple. Okay, you know what? That's close enough. Just hold tight.
All reactor core safeguards are now non-functional. Please prepare for reactor core meltdown.
Okay, look, I wasn't going to mention this to you, but I'm in pretty hot water here. How are you doing down there? You still holding on? The reserve power ran out, so of course the whole relaxation center stops waking up the bloody test subjects. Hold on, this is a bit tricky. And of course, nobody tells me anything. No, why should you tell me anything? Why should I be kept informed? You know, about the life functions of the 10,000 bloody test subjects I'm supposed to be in charge of. Why? It's close. Can you see? Am I going to make it through? Have I got enough space? Just got to get through here. I just got to concentrate. And whose fault do you think it's going to be when the management comes down here and finds 10,000 flipping vegetables? Ah, right, see, now I hear that one. Okay, listen, we should get our story straight, all right? If anyone asks, and no one's going to ask, don't worry, but if anyone asks, tell them as far as you know, the last time you checked, everyone looked pretty much alive, all right? Not dead. Okay, almost there. On the other side of that wall is one of the old testing tracks. There's a piece of equipment in there that we're going to need to get out of here. I think this is a docking station. Get ready. Good news, that is not a docking station. So there's one mystery solved. I'm going to attempt a manual override on this wall. Could get a bit technical. Hold on.
Manual
override on the wall. Remember, you're looking for a gun that makes holes. Not bullet holes. But don't worry, you'll figure it out. Seriously, do hold on this time. Look, there we go. Now, I'll be honest, you are probably in no fit state to run this particular type of cognitive gauntlet. But at least you're a good jumper. So you got the jumping on your side. Just do your best, and I'll meet you up ahead. That's the spirit.
All right. I'm liking this already just for the humor. Very funny. Alright. You've earned a trophy. Wake up call. I think I need to move myself down a little bit. Just give me one second here. Hang on. Yeah, maybe we'll just move down here for now, and then we'll see. See what we can see. Alright, cool. Oh!
Hello, and again, welcome to the Aperture Science Enrichment Center.
Holy
we
shit.
Are currently experiencing technical difficulties due to circumstances of potentially apocalyptic significance beyond our control. However, thanks to emergency testing protocols, testing can continue. These pre-recorded messages will provide instructional and motivational support so that science can still be done, even in the event of environmental, social, economic, or structural collapse. The portal will open, and emergency testing will begin in 3, 2, 1.
It's me again. Whoa, deja. It's like deja vu all over again.
Cube and button-based testing remains an important tool for science, even in a dire emergency. If cube and button-based testing caused this emergency, don't worry. The odds of this happening twice are very slim. Please note the incandescent particle field across the exit. This Aperture Science Material Emancipation Grill will vaporize any unauthorized equipment that passes through it.
Okay. Wow, it's definitely got like quite the graphical upgrade from the first one. All right, here we go. Stoutman said, nice Rickyism. It's like deja vu all over again.
If you feel liquid running down your neck, relax, lie on your back, and apply immediate pressure to your temples. You are simply experiencing a rare reaction in which the material emancipation grill may have emancipated the ear tubes inside your head.
I'm kind of nervous, because everything's broken and dirty and scary. Alright. Okay. Huh. Okay. Oh, here we are. I see. Alright, so that's there. So what do we need to do? We've got a cube there. Got a button there. Okay. Alright, so we'll go in there, we'll get the cube. Let's just leave this here. Okay, and we want this one. Okay. Definitely easier to put the boxes on the buttons in this one.
Put it on the button. The button. 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 I like buttons.
Good. Because of the technical difficulties we are currently experiencing, your test environment is unsupervised. Before re-entering a relaxation vault at the conclusion of testing, please take a moment to write down the results of your test.
an Aperture Science Reintegration Associate will revive you for an interview when society has been rebuilt.
Is there going to be a pile of boxes dropped on my head here? Okay, let's go. So many boxes up there. Press the button. Audio
still
okay,
the Earth is currently
everybody?
Governed by a manner of animal king, sentient cloud, or other governing body that either refuses to or is incapable of listening to reason.
Animal king takeover service announcement. Boom. We worship you because we want to live. Alright, cool. I like how the takeover thing looked like a giant robot. Kind of like those... It looks like those gun robots from the first one, except gigantic and leopard-spotted and with a crown. Level 2.
Hey! You made it!
Oh, hey, it's him.
There should be a portal device on that podium over there. I can't see it, though. Maybe it fell off. Do you want to go and have a quick look?
Hello! Oh, Jesus!
Hello? Can you see the portal gun? Also, are you alive? That's important. Should have asked that first. Do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to work on the assumption that you're still alive, and I'm just going to wait for you up ahead. I'll wait 1 hour, then I'll come back, and assuming I can locate your dead body, I'll bury you. Alright? Brilliant. Go, team! See you in an hour, hopefully. If you're not dead.
Oh, there's a portal. Oh, there it is. Oh, well, I gotta check out all these pictures here. So a bunch of scientists making GLaDOS from the looks of it. Craziness! Did that person's head get ripped off? And gifts of cake. Oh, and the companion cube. I found out you can get an inflatable companion cube ottoman. Whoa, that's me. Why are there like paintings of me and my story here? One in this one. I'm gonna take a picture of my butt. Or not. What, I can't pick it up? No. Oh, I can get a better view of that picture there. Oh, and the music's louder in this room. But then if I go in here, quiet again. It's almost like the music is actually in the room. What? Am I seeing the other side of the portal there? Weird. It's like I'm seeing through the wall. It's kind of weird.
Some emergency testing may require prolonged interaction with lethal military androids. Rest assured that all lethal military androids have been taught to read and provided with one copy of the Laws of Robotics. To share.
Great. Okay. I guess, I see. So I guess they're just doing that to show you where the two, where the other portals are, so you can kind of, you know, get your bearings, know where it is in relation to you, that sort of thing. Actually, no, let's just put it there. Put her there, pal.
Good. If you feel that a lethal military android has not respected your rights as detailed in the laws of robotics, please note it on your self-reporting form. A future Aperture Science Entitlement Associate will initiate the appropriate grievance filing paperwork.
Okay. I'm not fully trusting these elevators. Oh, what do we got here? Animal King takeover. It's the same thing again. What the hell? I'm confused. Alright. Where's that robot guy? Cool, well, I'm definitely intrigued so far. Lots of intrigue happening here.
This next test is very dangerous. To help you remain tranquil in the face of almost certain death, Smooth Jazz will be deployed in 3, 2, 1.
Yeah. Aww. I was getting so mellow. Oh, there's an orange one right there. All right, perfect. Whoops. All right, used to the Portal 1 controls. With Portal 1, it was R2 and L2. This one, it's R1 and L1. Oh, this is exactly the ones that were in Portal 1. Alright. Okay. Crap, where's the other one?
Great work. Because this message is pre-recorded, any observations related to your performance are speculation on our part. Please disregard any undeserved compliments.
Not what I was trying to do, but that works even better, actually. That's easier. Okay, hold on a second. What's up here? Oh. Unreason. Okay. Get through the door. Waiting for the avalanche of boxes again. Alright. Remember your evacuation training. Hop, 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 hop. Okay. So basically, to evacuate, you stand in place and do marching exercises. Gotcha. Brassfinger says, if you don't know what Doom smells like, it smells like old band-aids with a hint of tangerine. Seth Angel says, almonds. It smells like almonds. Alright. Remember,
if the Enrichment Center is currently being bombarded with fireballs, meteorites, or other objects from space, please avoid unsheltered testing areas wherever a lack of shelter from space debris does not appear to be a deliberate part of the test.
Makes sense. That's sound advice, disembodied voice guy. These aren't exactly the same. Oh. Really? What there? Whee! Okay. Alright, so put that there. Button? Oh. Oh, crap. Okay. Well, yeah, I didn't think that. That's too easy. Put one there. That's great. How does that help us, though? Yeah, this is not the same number 5 that was in the first one. Oh. I see. Hold it a second. Oh. Well, that doesn't. Oh, wait a second. Wait a second. I get it. I get it. Duh. Yes, I had the right idea. I was just looking at the wrong dispenser. There. Alright. There we go. Up the stairs we go. Alright, so we need one over there. Okay. So. Well. Why do I even need to use these? Why can't I just. I can just use the same dispenser, can I not? Whoa. The fuck? I'm confused. So what does this button do exactly? It just opens the door. Well, what is all this other shit here? Like, I don't see any purpose to it. Like what is that supposed to do? Creates a wall for me to fling myself into. Like, what? What this one? There we go. Oh! I get it. Well, what if I just do that one again? Like, why am I even bothering with that? Oh, I get it. Silly me. thinking that there was no point to anything in a room in a game of Portal. There is always a point to everything. Alright. So, we need to put that there. Need to push that. And push that. And there we go. So that keeps that from flying into the thing and the stuff. And then we can grab it and go up here. Okay, I got it. I got this.
Well done. The Enrichment Center reminds you that although circumstances may appear bleak, you are not alone. All Aperture Science personality constructs will remain functional in apocalyptic, low-power environments of as few as 1.1 volts.
Are you quite finished? Alright, here we go. Okay. So it is kind of starting off the same as the original Portal. So you're still doing puzzles and testing and stuff. But there's more stuff going on. Like, you got that robot dude who's trying to help you out. And
this next test applies the principles of momentum to movement through portals. If the laws of physics no longer apply in the future, God help you.
That's funny. Well, hopefully the rules of physics still apply. Alright, so it's a good old-fashioned fling. Alright, well, I guess... Oh, really? Well, that's just bullshit. Oh, here we go. Alright, before we do that, just take a quick boo around. There is a box in there. And there is a button up there. I see. Yeah. Oh, there we go. Fling! Alright, here we go. Whee! Okay. Guess I have to put a portal there first, don't I? Yeah, kinda. Something like that. There we go. Alright. Haha.
If you are a non-employee who has discovered this facility amid the ruins of civilization, welcome. And remember, testing is the future, and the future starts with you.
That's great. So cheerful in the face of the apocalypse. Yes, I was just going to say, I am the Fling Master. I can fling like nobody's business. I love to do all the flinging. Flinging to and fro, here and there and everywhere. Fling. Gah. I don't know what that was, but I hope you enjoyed it. Oh, weird. It actually... I wonder if this one just orients your portals correctly all the time. Let me, I don't... Well, I can't really put that to the test here, so... Alright. Fling Master! I honestly don't know where that's coming from, but I'm just gonna roll with it. Button over there. Portal there. Okay, so where? So we need to get over there and around the corner or something. Huh. Put it up there. As high as possible. Send me flying.
Hmm.
Here we go.
Button. Oh, okay. It's just, it's right there. Excellent. What? Hey, wait. Why are you up there? Hold on. I should be here, I think. All right. Well, let's Yes. Oh, damn it. Fuck you.
Good work getting this far, future starter. That said, if you are simple-minded, bold, or irradiated in such a way that the future should not start with you, please return to your primitive tribe and send back someone better qualified for testing.
It definitely pays to have played the first one first. Because, I mean, you could just jump right into this one, for sure. But, for the most part, I'd say it is beneficial to have played the first one, because I know if I hadn't, I would be struggling a lot more with these puzzles right now.
To ensure that sufficient power remains for core testing protocols, all safety devices have been disabled. The Enrichment Center respects your right to have questions or concerns about this policy.
Okay.
Hey! Oi, oi!
Oh!
Come up here!
I was just wondering where he went. Where? Where are you? Seven. Okay, that's all smashed.
Oh, brilliant!
Oh, there
he
you are!
He did find a portal gun! Oh, do you know what? It just goes to show, people with brain damage are the real heroes in the end, aren't they, at the end of the day? Brave. Pop a portal on that wall behind me there, and I'll meet you on the other side of the room. Okay, listen, let me lay something on you here. It's pretty heavy. They told me never, never, ever to disengage myself from my management rail, or I would die. But we're out of options here, so get ready to catch me, all right, on the off chance that I'm not dead the moment I pop off this thing. On three. Ready? One. Two. Three! That's high. It's too high, isn't it, really, that?
Damn it.
All right, going on three just gives you too much time to think about it. Let's go on one this time. Okay, ready? One.
Catch me, catch me! Ow!
Damn it.
Ow. Bye. I'm not dead! I'm not dead! Plug me into that stick on the wall over there, yeah? And I'll show you something. You'll be impressed by this.
What stick? Where?
Go on, just jam me in over there.
Oh, over there. Okay.
Yeah, I can't do it if you're watching. Seriously, I'm not joking. Could you just turn around for a second? Alright, you can turn around now. Bam! Secret panel. That I opened while your back was turned. Pick me up.
And off we go.
Look at this! No rail to tell us where to go. Oh, this is brilliant. We can go wherever we want. Just hold on though, where are we going? Hang on, let me just get my bearings. Just follow the rail, actually.
I like this guy.
Hello.
Oh no.
Yes, hello, no, we're not stopping.
Don't make eye contact, whatever you do.
No, thanks, we're good. Appreciate it.
Keep moving, keep moving.
Hello.
Hello. Okay. Seth Angel says Z is doing better than I expected. Damn it. stout, ever confident, says, "Oh, that won't last long." Skinslip says, "Zero Nazarek subtitles." I was just thinking that. I do apologize, my hard of hearing friends. Okay, why are we saving? Can we just get to the? Thank you. There we go. Audio, video. Yeah, let's just do subtitles. No, that should be fine. Okay, there we go. All right. Terribly sorry, everybody. We have subtitles now.
Probably ought to bring you up to speed on something right now. In order to escape, we're going to have to go through her chamber. And she will probably kill us if she's awake. If you want to just call it quits, we could just sit here forever. That's an option. Option A, sit here, do nothing. Option B, go through there. And if she's alive, she'll almost certainly kill us. So, if you've got any reservations whatsoever about this plan, now would be a tremendous time to voice them. Right now. In case you thought to yourself, I've missed the window of time to voice my reservations. It's still open.
Alright. So his name is Wheatley. I am liking Wheatley. So you have to go through her chamber. I'm guessing that's GLaDOS's chamber.
Okay, I'm gonna lay my cards on the table. I don't wanna do it. I don't wanna go in there. Don't go in there. She's off. She's off. Don't panic over her. She's off. All fine. On we go. There she is. What a nasty piece of work she was, honestly. Like a proper maniac. Do you know who ended up taking her down in the end? You're not gonna believe this. A human. I know, I wouldn't have believed either. Apparently this human escaped and nobody's seen him since. Then there was a sort of long chunk of time where absolutely nothing happened. And then there's us escaping now, so that's pretty much the whole story. You're up to speed. Don't touch him.
All that's left.
Okay, down these stairs. Jump! That's quite a distance, isn't it? Okay, you know what? Go ahead and jump. You've got braces on your legs, so you're all set. Although no braces on your arms, though, so you're going to have to rely on the old human strength to keep a grip on the device and, by extension, me. So do really make sure you keep a grip on me. Also, a note, no braces on your spine either, so don't land on that. Or your head, no braces there. That could split like a melon from this height. So do definitely focus on landing with your legs. Quick question. Have you been working out? Because, I'll be honest, there's no evidence of it. You know, I'm not like just a plastic cup. We will be landing with some force, so bit of grip. Just using grip, classic grip. Right, let's go. Jump. What's the worst that could happen? Oh, I just thought about the worst thing that could happen. I just thought of something even worse. Better plan. A new plan. No imagining of any potential outcomes whatsoever. Okay, just jump. Just jump into the abyss and see what happens. Oh, it's still there. It's still in my head.
Are you ready now? Let's go.
Oh, still held! Still being held. That's a great job. You've applied the grip. We're all fine. That's tremendous.
I do like this Wheatley. He's wonderfully British and hilarious. Alright.
I just looked down. I do not recommend it. Ah! I've just done it again. This is the main breaker room. Let's go in. Look for a switch that says escape pod. All right, don't touch anything else. Not interested in anything else. Don't touch anything else. Don't even look at anything else. Obviously you've got to look at everything else to find the escape pod. But as soon as you look at something and it doesn't say escape pod, look at something else. Look at the next thing, all right? But don't touch anything else or look at anything. Well, look at other things, but don't... Yeah. You understand?
I'm just going to say...
Can you see it anywhere? Yeah. I can't see it anywhere. Tell you what, plug me in and I'll turn the lights on.
Oh, okay.
Let there be light. That's, God. He's quoting God. Oh, look at that! Turning. Ominous. But probably fine, as long as it doesn't start, you know, moving up. Now. Escape pod. It's moving up. Okay,
no, don't worry. I've got it. This should slow it down.
Oh.
No, makes it go faster.
Uh-oh.
Power up initiated.
Panic. All right, stop panicking.
Oh, shit.
I can still stop this.
Oh, shit.
There's a password. Okay,
this fine. This is not good.
Not a problem.
This is very not good.
No.
We don't want that to happen.
Wait, did I do the jump pen? Start writing these down.
Power up, complete.
I don't. Okay. Listen. All right. New plan. Act natural. We've done nothing wrong.
Hi.
Hello? Oh, it's you.
You know her?
It's been a long time. How have you been? I've been really busy being dead. You know, after you murdered me.
You did what?
Oh, shit.
Okay, look. We both said a lot of things that you're going to regret. But I think we can put our differences behind us. For science.
Poor Wheatley.
You monster. I will say, though, that since you went to all the trouble of waking me up, you must really, really love to test. I love it, too. There's just one small thing we need to take care of first.
Well, shit just got real.